同学们好，我是加拿大安省在线高中 Ontario Virtual School 的招生经理桑尼老师，同时也是在加拿大的留学生和家长亲切称呼的仙妈或者仙妈老师。今天我来给大家介绍我们安省在线高中 Ontario Virtual School 的9年级科学这门课程。在安省，9年级科学呢是一个必修的学分。它呢是没有前置课程要求的，它的课程代码是 SNCED。这门课程我们安省在线高中是有哪些课程内容设置，然后又有哪些要求呢？下面我先来带大家看一下我们专门为这门课程而录制的一个视频介绍。
Grade 9 science allows students to develop their understanding of basic concepts in biology, chemistry, earth and space science, and physics, and relates these areas of study to technology, society, and the environment. Throughout this course, students will learn the essential processes of scientific investigation, which form the basis for all future paths of study across the sciences. Through the various units of this course, students will acquire an understanding of scientific theories and conduct investigations related to sustainable ecosystems, study atomic and molecular structures and the properties of elements and compounds, explore the universe and discover its properties and components, and learn the basic principles of electricity that have helped shape our modern society. SNC1D will cover the following units. Biology. Our planet is filled with so much life. This unit will teach us how all living things are influenced by others and their environment. We will understand what we can do to make sure that this important relationship is protected and conserved. Chemistry. Everything is made up of matter. And since chemistry is the study of matter, chemistry is basically the study of absolutely everything, including you. In this unit, we learn about the periodic table, which lists all the types of matter found on Earth. We will also show you how these types of matter combine to make some amazing new compounds, each with their own special properties that make life possible. Earth and space science. Humans have been fascinated by the mysterious objects found in the night sky for centuries. Scientists and engineers have developed so many amazing tools to help us see these objects in our never-ending quest to better understand our universe. Things like telescopes, satellites, and even the space station, which allows people to actually live in outer space. In this unit, we will also be discussing the theory of the Big Bang in an effort to understand how our amazing universe was created in the first place. Physics. If you've ever experienced a blackout or participated in Earth Hour, you must know just how crucial electricity has become to our society. In this unit, we look more closely at how electricity is created and used in our daily lives. We will explore the properties of electricity using some pretty neat calculations, and we'll investigate electric circuits using diagrams and e-labs.
刚才呢，大家通过我们的视频介绍，知道了我们这门课程对课程内容的一些设置。接下来，我带领大家进入到我们这门课程本身，看看我们该如何学习，有哪些要求。这是我们这门课程的后台界面，这个是课程代码 SNCED。这门课程一共有51课，其中有10个要交的计分项，那么这10个都是必须交的。我们这门课程呢，可能你报相同的课程，轮到的不是同一位辅导老师，但是你的辅导老师实时在线的时间也会在这里有显示。当老师实时在线的时候呢，你可以在这里跟老师实时的沟通，老师会实时的回复。如果老师不是实时在线的时间呢，那这是他的留言板，他会把重要的信息留在这里。你也可以通过他的电子邮件跟他进行沟通。这门课程我们要上交的作业呢，都是从 Dropbox 来交的。 啊，如果你要交某一个作业的时候呢，请点击加号，然后点击这里，从电脑里面选取你的作业的文件，然后上传，就可以把你的作业永远留在上面，我们的老师会给批改。老师批改过的这个作业，以及这个大家看到这里面呢是老师需要计分的这些作业项目，那么老师如果批改过呢，这边就会有分数的显示。大家看到我们这门课程计分项呢，多数是实验课的作业。这门课程有一个期末考试。在 resources 里面呢，会列出我们这门课程给予大家的免费的资料。那我们是包括免费的电子书，电子书呢是有这个免费的习题和答案的。在每一个章节测验的时候呢，我们会有这个模拟测验题和答案。然后呢，在物理课做实验，我们会给大家一个这个实验的方法。这门课程的免费的电子书，我在这里呢跟大家先展示一下。这个是大家报这门课程呢就会免费的得到的一门电子书，是我们开发的，图文并茂的，内容非常的详尽，一共有245页。刚才说过了，这门课程的练习题和答案以及模拟题呢也都是免费给大家的。如果做章节测验的话呢，请进入到 Test Center， 这里我不再赘述。我们这一门课程呢，刚才有知道一共有5个 unit。那我现在呢先带大家进入到其中一个 unit。
Welcome to Unit One, Adams,
我们可以点击这个符号呢，进入到全屏学习的方式，可以按照任意的顺序来安排你的学习。
Welcome to Moo Moo Math and Science.
如果学习当中有这个视频插入的话呢，它会自动接入。
Chemical changes. Physical changes are changes in appearance only. A new substance is not created, and chemical bonds are not formed or broken. For example.Take this stack of paper and wadding it up into smaller pieces is a physical change. It still has the same properties as the original paper. Cutting someone's hair is a physical change because the hair has the same properties as the original.
Physical changes involve a change in state. This is very obvious and easy to see.The particles, of course, remain the same because we know that a change in state is only a change in the amount of space between particles. This image shows the different physical changes that are possible, going from gas to liquid to solid and vice versa. There's another state that has gotten a lot of attention in the science community recently, which is plasma or ionized gas particles. You can see in the particle diagram that during state changes, the particles stay the same, and it is only the amount of space between them that changes.
On Earth, everything is made up of matter. It's everything around us. Heavy rocks are made of matter, and even things we can't see, like air, are made of matter. Even your friends are made of matter.If it takes up space, then it's matter. Matter is made up of atoms and molecules, which are too tiny to see unless you have a very...
时间关系呢，我们再进入到其他的章节来看一下啊。我们随便找一个课程，电池，这是物理方面的。
Welcome to Unit 3, Characteristics of Electricity.Lesson 13, Batteries. At some point in your life, you've probably used a battery. Batteries are portable sources of energy. How do they work, what makes them work, and why do they come in different shapes and sizes? These are some of the questions we'll be answering in this lesson. Throughout our history, there have been many scientists that have experimented with trying to produce energy. Most of these attempts were very similar.As they try to make use of different metals called electrodes and a liquid solution called an electrolyte, which is typically made up of an acidic environment. They all experimented with a chemical reaction called a redox reaction that takes place so that electrons from one of the metals transfer to the metals of another.
When I say power, you probably think of a power outlet. But the fact is, batteries were used long before electrical grids or generators were in use.
还是时间的关系呢，我们就不把这个视频呢给大家看的更多，我们再多体验一下课程吧。
As mentioned earlier in the introduction, we know that batteries come in all shapes and sizes. However, the majority of the batteries are 1.5 volts. The exception to that is a square battery, which has 9 volts.The reason why they are different is the amount of current that the battery carries. Larger batteries will carry more current and will last longer than a smaller one, even if the voltage is the same. It is also dependent on the device that is using the battery. Larger devices would require larger batteries with stronger current, whereas smaller devices require less.
You probably know the feeling. Your phone utters its final plaintive bleep and cuts out in the middle of your call. In that moment, you may feel more like throwing your battery across the room than singing its praises. But batteries are a triumph of science. They allow smartphones and other technologies to exist. With
Welcome to Unit 4, The sun is a massive ball of gas. Predominantly, it is made up of hydrogen and helium. In terms of size, we know the sun is incredibly big. It has almost 110 times the diameter of Earth, yet it's less dense because it's made mainly of gases. It's important to understand that the sun is not...
While billions of stars are scattered throughout the universe, the one at the center of our solar system...
好，时间关系，我们就分享课程到这里。大家知道我们的课程呢，就是这样的一个学习方式。那我们老师的讲解以及我们精心准备的这些音频和视频的资料呢，会随时给大家接触到。那么会给大家对这门课程要进行的内容是如何的、清晰的有一个认识呢，会有很大的帮助。如果大家想要报这门课程九年级科学课，那么是报名的方法呢，我们是同样所有的课程都接受学分和非学分两种方式来报名、这两种方式呢，报名接触的这个课件的内容呢是完全一样的。刚才我给大家展示的所有的免费的教材，所有的这个老师讲解的内容呢，这两种方式都能够接触到。唯一的区别就是非学分方式我们不给大家配这个在线老师，所以呢学生可、不需要交作业，也不会取得分数和学分。但是非学分方式，如果你对我们的课程真的有信心，你可以随时补齐这个报名的资料和学费，把它转为学分方式，通过学分方式呢，从我们学校取得这门课程的成绩和学分。报名所需要的资料是我们列在这里，如果大家需要索取报名表格，请扫屏幕右方的二维码，或者如果有问题请联系我们，扫二维码联系我们的、招生老师。在中国的学生也同样可以注册加拿大的学籍，从而通过我们的网课修得加拿大的这个学分，取得加拿大的毕业证。这个呢，如果大家有问题欢迎联系我们详询。通过我们中文部门来报名与通过官网报名有一点区别，官网呢非学分方式是不能报名的，同时通过我们中文部来报名呢，我们会为学生提供中文的这个 guidance 老师服务，我们有中文微信可以跟学生和家长进行沟通，方便家长了解学生的学习进度。同时我们中文部有市场活动的话呢，这个优惠是可以直减的。我们的课程适合于任何阶段，在来留学之前以及留学之后，甚至在疫情下从加拿大回到中国的学生，仍然可以通过我们的网课来使你的学业不被干扰。欢迎大家随时联系我们了解详情。最后呢，再次感谢大家的时间，祝所有的同学都能够成功留学，留学成功，欢迎大家随时联系我们，谢谢，再见。